What's so funny?
Nothing.
What did you bring for us today?
Today, I want to talk about two zirconia crowns that had a de-cementation. They just detached from the sleeves. The cement stayed on the sleeves. You can see that you don't have any residues of cement. You have the composite material that closed the hole, but the sleeves just detached, the crowns just detached from the sleeves.
It just fell down.
Just fell down. And this happened because, first of all, they made from zirconia. And zirconia is very problematic material. When you're making crowns from zirconia, it's very hard to cement zirconia to something. It's very hard material, it's very good material, but it's very problematic for the cementation process. So you have different types of bonding, different types of etching that you can make the zirconia to process it with. But nothing is good as the PFM with the cementation or different materials with cementation. Zirconia is not that good as all of the other material, all of the other materials. So what can we do to help the zirconia attach to the sleeves? When we're making, when we're cementing the zirconia, first of all, we need to have a clean material, very clean zirconia. We need to clean it with alcohol or something to for the surface to be clean without any contaminants. Now, this will help with the micro retentions, but still we need to have some macro retentions. We need to have some undercuts for the cement to get into and to hold the bridge. So we made...
So basically we're doing the undercuts to make the surface area bigger.
First of all, make the surface area bigger. And secondly, this way, you can't just remove the crowns. You need to break the cement to remove them. They're not so easily removable. Mm-hmm. We made a small video that shows how we're making them. You can see here, this is the zirconia before the sintering process. And we take a very small burr, and with this burr, we're making very small undercuts in the part that it's inside the crown. It's very important to do this before the sintering process, because after the sintering process, the zirconia is very hard and it's very difficult to make this kind of undercuts in the material itself. So in here you can see that we have a cross arm bridge from the zirconia, 12 units, I think, and in each slot for each sleeve, what we're doing is we're making small undercuts in the parallel surfaces, so we can, when we will attach the sleeves, the cement will get into those undercuts and the sleeves will hold much better in the zirconia.
I see, and you're doing it in every cemented restoration. It's recommended to do this undercuts.
I recommend it for every zirconia restoration because with the cement, with undercuts, you have much more surface. The cement holds much better. When you're using sleeves that are not parallel, for example, for the D-type, it's even much more important because the unparallel walls of the sleeves in the zirconia will make the de-cementation process much easier, and you want to hold the sleeve inside the zirconia. So with the undercuts, it's much easier to hold the sleeve inside the zirconia.
So if you're using a PFM bridge on cement restoration, can you do the same because the PFM inside is metal? So how are you doing the undercuts?
You can, but you don't need to because the metal is not polished inside, and you
It's rigid.
You have micro and micro retentions in the PFM crown itself. So first of all, it will the cement will hold much better. But then when you cement a PFM, the cement gluing, sticking, the adhesion between the cement and the metal is much better than between the cement and the zirconia.
Mm-hmm. The zirconia is just... has, because it's smoother, it has less adhesion.
Not just smoother, but the material itself.
The material itself.
Yeah, is less adhesive.
Mm-hmm. And why are you doing this before the sintering process?
after the before the sintering, the zirconia is like a gypsum. You can easily remove it, you can easily polish it, you can do whatever you want. But after the sintering process, the zirconia is very hard. It's like rock. You need diamond burrs, you need cooling, you need different methods.
And it can chip and break.
Yeah, because the zirconia can chip and break and you don't want it to chip and break. It's much difficult after the sintering process. And if you do this after the sintering process, there is a possibility that you insert in some unwanted forces into the material because you're heating it a little bit. So before the sintering process, much better, much easier, and I don't see any reason why not to do this.
So only positivity?
Yeah, only positivity.
So it's a must?
I think yes.
Thank you very much for being with us today.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow to stay tuned with the latest cases. Thank you and have a great week.